Hello, everyone. My name is Sam Kinnett, and I'm a product evangelist here at Appian, and I am so excited to be here with you today for the start of our new series centered around a complete build-from-scratch application. Through this series, we will be starting from absolutely nothing and working our way up to the final product of a complete and functioning application. The use case we will be working on will be centered around customer applications. Whether applying for an event or inquiring about a partnership, external customers will be able to submit their applications through a portal for review. In this application, they will provide their company name and also a couple of necessary documents. From here, we will use AI skills to verify that the customer submitted the correct documents, as well as using Appian RPA to have a robot go out and retrieve the company's ESG score from a website. Feel free to follow along the series to see exactly how this is done, but the course instructions are also available on Academy Online, which will be linked in the description below. With that being said, let's go ahead and get started with the first part of this series, which involves setting the foundation of our application. Sound good? Over here on my screen, from our Appian Designer, we're going to go ahead and select New Application. And as mentioned, this is going to be our Customer Application application. Kind of dual words there. We're going to let Appian go ahead and generate groups and folders to secure and organize our objects. You can see it automatically generates our prefix, and we're going to go ahead and click Create. Now, once that happens, you're going to see this box pop up with our default security settings that Appian provides. We're gonna go ahead and just save those as is. No changes necessary there. And immediately we're dumped within our application, and here's where we can start setting up our foundation. The first thing we're gonna do is create a new record type. This is where we're gonna be storing all of our data. We will call this, again, customer application. The display name will be automatically set for us, and we'll go ahead and click create. Now, as mentioned, this is a complete build from scratch, and we don't have this data existing anywhere. So as before, we're going to go ahead and click to save our default security settings. And then because, as I said, we don't have this data already existing anywhere, we're going to go ahead and create our own new database. Now, to do this, we're going to use Appian's codeless data modeling. So from here, for tell us about your data, we are going to select new data model and go ahead and click next. And we'll select our data source. In this case, we'll use Appian. Now, the wonderful thing about this is I can use Appian's codeless data modeling to go ahead and create my database structure without needing to go into the database at all. I need to have no prior knowledge of SQL. It'll handle it all for me, no problems at all. So with that, we're going to go ahead and update our database by removing the created by, modified by, and modified on fields. We'll add the name from the commonly used fields. This will be the company name that they input into our portal for their application. And then we're also going to add two new fields. So we'll click this button here, go ahead and click two and enter. And this first one is going to be the ESG score. So when we kick off that RPA process and it retrieves that ESG score, it'll store it within this data for that company. This will be of type number integer. And then the last thing we need to check for, because as mentioned, they will be submitting documents with their application, we need to verify that, do they have the correct documents? We're just going to put a Boolean check in there that will be determined from our AI skill model. So now that we have our data structure set up for our customer applications, we can go ahead and go through the rest of the wizard for creating this record type. We'll go ahead and go through. Everything looks good on our end, so we'll click Save Changes. You'll see down we have the create table checked because we want to create that table in our database. And once completed, you'll see that there's also an option to download our database script. And what this is our SQL, everything that we just did. And so I always keep that checked because it's wonderful to have in case you ever need it. Also, if you're deploying up between environments, it's always nice to have that so you can use that SQL and go ahead and directly implement it into that new environment. And voila, you're done from there. So as you can see, we've already created our first record type object for storing our data. Let's go ahead and do one more. As mentioned, we are going to have documents uploaded with the application. And so we need a place to store those documents, and we're going to store those in a separate record type. So we're going to go ahead and call this one document. Again, the display name is already created for us, so nothing to worry about there. And we will save our default security settings. So here we are. And we're going to do the same thing as before. We're going to create a new data model for our record type. Select Appian as our data source again. And then we're going to remove all of these fields because we no longer need any of this metadata as we're capturing it in our initial record type. and this will be created as a related record. So we're going to go ahead and create two new fields again. And this one will be of number integer. And this field is going to be our document ID. So the identifier of that document that was submitted. And then we're also going to have a type. As mentioned, documents will be uploaded. What type are they? This will be able to. This will be where we store that information for reference later on, and also verifying that they do have the correct documents uploaded. Now, we need a way to relate this to our main application. Here we can select from our suggested record types. You see here, customer application. Let's go ahead and select that. We'll keep it many to one because an application will have several documents. And you see that Appian goes ahead and creates a common field for us, customer application ID. So easy enough. I'm just going to go ahead, stumbled over my words there, and click add, and click next to look at our final data model. Here you can see all of our necessary fields configured, as well as our relationship over on the right, showing how documents relate to each application. So again, as the previous steps, we're going to go ahead and click save changes. And download that database script as well, just so we have it for future reference. Now, we need to go back to our original customer application record type. I'm going to refresh here so I can get that information to load in. And we're going to add the other side of that relationship so we can access it later on. Now, one last thing I'm going to do before I save changes is I'm going to go ahead and create a record action. This is going to allow us to easily kick off creating our process model as well as our interface for when a customer does want to submit an application. It'll go ahead and create the necessary objects for us with naming convention and security, and we don't have to do anything. So it's pretty wonderful, I'm not gonna lie. Definitely saves me a lot of time. So I'm gonna remove the update and delete options because we only want customers to be able to create a new application. And with that, we're gonna click generate. I trust Appian to name it all correctly, so I'm not gonna customize here. And when I generate, you'll see here on my application, my customer application record type, that the action will show up with the process model, as well as all those objects will be available within my build view in my objects container. So that looks great. Looks like it went through. We have our new process model here, our new action with our process model. Great. Everything's working out perfectly. We now have our foundation of our application built out. We have our data structures. We have our initial process model and start process form for submitting a new application. So we're in a really good spot at this point. The last thing I'm gonna do is we are gonna go ahead and start training our AI skill model to learn based on documents that we provide it. And the reason we're gonna do this is because it does take a little bit of time, especially with two different document types and the documents we're gonna give it, for the model to go through the documents and learn and train itself. And so it's always better to do this at the start so that when we get time to implementing that AI skill model into our process, Our document classification is already trained. It's good to go, and we don't need to do any more extra waiting. So as I mentioned, we're going to go back here to our main application and go to our build view where all of our objects are. Now, as mentioned, we are going to create a new AI skill object. Now, what are we going to be using this object for exactly? We're going to be using this object for document classification. When a customer submits their documents, we want to classify these documents into a certain type and then be able to verify that they submitted the correct document based on its classification. So the documents that they're going to be uploading are a non-disclosure agreement and a payment authorization form. So with that being said, let's go ahead and select our document classification skill here. We are going to name it document classification. And let's click create. Again, it's going to generate our default security, which we're happy with as always. And we're pushed right into our AI skill object. Now, obviously, we don't have any models. We got to train our model to learn based on the documents that we are going to give it for testing. Now, I already have those documents on me, but if you are doing this on your own or through the instructions, they will be linked to you for download that you can then input them into your model. So as mentioned, let's go ahead and click create first model. And we're going to add new document type. As mentioned, we are going to have two different document types. This one, no need for a dash. Don't know why I did that, is the payment authorization form. Now, as I mentioned, these are actually available to me on my computer. So I am just going to select them if I can, and I'm going to drag them right over into our upload field here and let all of them process and upload. As we're waiting on this, you can see here on the right, a couple requirements for training. You want to give it at least 10 documents. The more is better. The more training objects it has, the better and more accurate it can be. They all do need to be PDF files, and they all need to be unique. So this will help the document classification model train and teach itself. So when it's used in the real world, it is as accurate as possible in classifying documents. Looks like all of our documents went through. We are going to create and add one more type. As I mentioned, here's where the dash comes into play. We're going to have a non-disclosure agreement. I also have those documents over here. Let me see if I can get these over a little quicker. I think I can. And again, it's going to go through each one of those. Just make sure it's meeting our requirements of PDFs. And there's at least 10 documents. If not, it'll get a little upset at you, but you can just throw in a couple more in there until you meet that requirement. So look, now we're all set. We're going to go ahead and create these. So now you can see our two different document types are in there, our payment authorization form and our non-disclosure agreement. We are going to save changes before we start training the model. And now that we're good to go, we're going to train it. And just like that, our model is in training. Nothing else for us to do. We're going to let it do its thing. We're going to sit back and relax. And in no time, it'll be ready to go and we can implement it into our process. And that's it. Just like that, we have successfully set the foundation for our application as well as started the training for our AI skill document classification model. If you liked this video, check the description below for additional viewing suggestions, as well as subscribe to our channel so that you can stay up to date on all the newest videos we are releasing. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video when we build and publish the portal.